A very good morning to all my dear children. I hope you all are fine. I hope you listened to my yesterday's video properly and you have understood the lesson and you are following all the guidelines which I have given in that video and which you are getting in instruction from others also. Please always do the same things whenever you are going outside. Okay, wash your hands, wear the mask, social distancing, maintain a proper 6 feet distance from the people around you. Okay, and one thing children more I want to tell you that you all are following all the guidelines, all the measures to be safe from this virus. But one thing more which you can't do is eat good food. Eat the food which is rich in vitamin C, zinc and all so that your immune system is also good. So that if in by chance you get infected by this virus, you can strongly fight with the virus. Because it's only the case, it is the only thing required to beat this virus is your own immune system. If you are strong from inside, then you can surely fight this with the virus. Neither the virus will affect you. If the virus by chance can affect you also, then also you can get rid from it if your immune system is strong. Okay, moving towards the today's class of English literature. Today is children 3rd of November 2020 and today we are going to start off with the lesson number 9 of your English literature and the name of the lesson is The Paper Crane. Now, before starting this is a small story, it's a very nice story children. Before starting the story, I would like to tell you the characters, main characters of the story. What are the main characters of the story? The main character of the story are, there are three things in this. First one, a restaurant owner, then is a stranger, and the third and the very important character of the story is a paper crane. As the name of the story is the paper crane. I hope you know the meaning of word paper, the paper which we are using for writing and all, and crane. Crane, children, here is a bird. Crane is the name of the bird. Okay, and crane, in this story, the crane is made by a paper. In your art and all, we used to make things, board, different things with the help of paper. In this story, the crane is made by the paper. So, that is why the crane is called the paper crane. Now, I'll tell you this. Now, children, let's see the characters of the story. The story revolves around basically two characters. Restaurant owner and a stranger, but the main and the very important character of the story is a paper crane, the crane made up of paper. First I'll describe both the characters. See, I hope you all know what is the meaning of a restaurant. I hope many times you also go with your parents for having lunch or dinner outside. The place where we go outside to have lunch or dinner is known as the restaurant. Okay, this is a very common and a familiar word to all of you. A restaurant owner, a person who owns the restaurant, whose restaurant is, the name of the person is known as a restaurant owner. Now see children, this restaurant owner is a very kind, very sincere and a very kind-hearted and a very humble man. He is very good man. He always treat all his customers, all the people who came to his restaurant for having food and all, he always treat them very nicely. And the most and the very good thing of this man is that he always treat all the people nicely. Whether the person is rich, whether the person is poor. Sometimes if by chance some poor person came to his restaurant, the one who is not having the money also to pay for the food, then also this man treat that person also very nicely. And maybe he gave him food for free of cost also. That kind of heart this man is having. Okay, now then a stranger. In this story, there is a stranger, means a strange person whom the particular person don't know. The person whom we don't know is a stranger for us. The whom we know is that is a known person. The person whom we don't know is a stranger. So this stranger, this man is a stranger for the restaurant owner. He don't know the man, but this man is also a very gentle man. He was very poor. He was not able to pay the money and all for the food. He went for eating in the restaurant owner's restaurant, but he was not ashamed of being poor. He frankly said, sir, I'm not having the food or money to pay for your food, but I'm very hungry. So he was also a very gentleman. And now about the paper crane. A paper crane. This paper crane was gifted to the restaurant owner by the stranger. Okay, now what is the role of the paper cane in the story? That you will understand when I'll tell you the summary. So I hope the characters are clear to you, both the characters. Now, if we start off with the summary of the story, children, what happened? There is a man who has a restaurant, okay, on a busy road. Busy road means, children, the road which is always busy with the people, the place where every now and then one other person, it's very crowded place, and where every now and then people are coming for the shopping and eating or whatever. The road, the restaurant owner was having a restaurant at a very good place where every now and then people are coming and going. So as a result, her restaurant, his restaurant was also running very good. Every now and then, a very quite good number of customers were there at her, at his restaurant. But not what happened suddenly, as the restaurant was on the roadside, government constructed a highway. I hope you know the highway, children. We have studied in SST also, the roads which connect two cities or two states is known as the highway. A highway was constructed by the government, but by chance that highway road was constructed just next to the restaurant of this man. So what happened, all the marketplace and all got disturbed. The markets were stopped because on highway we cannot have a market. So just next to the highway the restaurant was there. Earlier what happened, that road was so busy, every now and then customers were coming, sitting there having the food, so he was having a good earning. But now, due to the construction of this highway, what happened, that road start moving, means no, the stoppage was finished. Now nobody is coming there to stop, just they are passing through the highway and going from there. Nobody is stopping. As a result, what happened, the slowly the number of customers to his restaurant got reduced, and a time came when there were no customers in his restaurant. He was only left with a chair, table and the groceries which he was having in the restaurant. He was very sad. He was sad to know how I'm going to earn my living, how I'm going to earn money, how I'm going to feed myself and my family. But the very good quality of this man was that he didn't get arrogant, he didn't get angry of all this. He was a very patienceful man. He didn't lose his patience, he was calm, but he continuously keep on praying to God that give some way, something happens so that his restaurant startups again. So as I told you in the starting only, he was a very kind man. He was kind to everyone, whether a person is rich or a poor. And children, whenever you are kind, your kindness always pays you back. When you are doing good to others, that good will in any of the way can come to you. That same thing happened to this man. One day, a stranger, as I told you, a person whom he don't know, came and visited his restaurant. That person was very poor. He was not wearing the clothes, and also clothes also not so good. Here and there clothes were torn out, dirty also. The man was not in a good condition. That stranger was not in a good condition. He was very poor. As he entered the restaurant, he said that, "Sir, I'm very hungry. I've not eaten food from few days. But my problem is that I'm not having any money." So that man said, "Okay, you don't worry. I'll just come inside, wash your hands and all. Then you said, I'll serve you the food." Then the stranger again repeated and said, "Sir, I'm not having the money to pay for your food." This restaurant owner, what did he say? "You need not worry about the money. I'll manage. You just sit nicely and have the food. How much you want to eat, you eat and fill up your hunger." So what happened? Now this man sat nicely, and the restaurant owner served his best meal to the stranger. He didn't say that he is not having money anyhow, kuch bhi khila do chalega. No, he served him the best food. Although his restaurant was running at zero customer, he was not having any customer. He would have thought that why I should waste my food for this man. But no, in spite of so much trouble also, he said no, the person who had came is a poor and he is very hungry, he is in the need of food. In spite of all the troubles the man himself was having, he helped that stranger. As I told you children, whenever you help somebody, whenever you show kindness to somebody without any revert, means this, as the restaurant owner was giving food to the stranger, he was not expecting anything from back from him, because he was not having the money, what he will give. But he did the kindness, he did this kind act of kindness without any revert, means he didn't thought that I'll get something from him. But as I told you children, God is there, God is watching everything, whatever you are doing with others, the God returns you back with the double, whatever you are doing. So this restaurant owner did a act of kindness to this man, and in return, what happened, when he has finished all his food and all, while going from the restaurant, what did this stranger do? He just picked up a paper napkin from there and he folded the paper and made a crane from that particular paper. Now, what did he say to the owner of the restaurant? That, dear, thank you so much for the such a good food that you have served me. I'll never forget this. Now, you just keep this crane with you. Okay. So, what happened? Now, the stranger told the man that this crane is going to dance whenever you will clap. And this man went off. Now, what happened? After hearing this, the paper crane is dancing, the people around the restaurant got very excited. Okay, let's come and see what is this crane dancing and all. So, one by one, slowly, one, two, three, number of people came to just see the crane. So, when they came there to see that crane, a man clapping and the paper crane started dancing, flying and dancing. So slowly the people came, and what happened? This affected the business of this restaurant owner. The people, when they came to see the crane, they would like to eat something also. Then slowly its business start up. 1, 2, 4, then 20, then 30, then 40, then 100. Like this, his business grew up with the help of that crane. So, what did you learn from this, children? That restaurant owner did everything without any feeling of getting something from that stranger. He did everything in a very humble and with a very kind heart. So in return, what he got a blessing from that stranger, that because of him his restaurant started earning a good money, because the number of customers start increasing slowly. And as I told you in the starting, only this man cooks also very good. So when somebody eats for the first time, he likes his food, and then he tell to other, like this, the number of customers to his restaurant started increasing. Then after a few days, the same man came to his restaurant again, and immediately that restaurant owner identified that, you are the same person. Then what happened? He didn't say anything. He quietly took out a flute. Now, what is a flute, children? Flute is a musical instrument. Played. Okay, so what did he did? What that stranger did with that flute? He take out the flute from his pocket. He play a nice tune on that with the help of that flute, and then immediately the crane started dancing with the flying and dancing. So the people around sitting, they all enjoyed it, and slowly then the stranger sat on the crane and flew away forever. Then that man was never seen. But this story of crane and the strangers spread around the village, spread around the area of the restaurant, and many people just came to see the restaurant. So like this, her restaurant was always full, and he earned a very good money from that restaurant. What we learn from the story, children, that kindness always pays back. Okay, but only when we are not doing the act of kindness in the greed of getting something, in the greed of getting a reward. We should always try to help others with a pure heart, without any grudge in inside that, I'm going doing good to this person, so I'll get good also from. Maybe possible that particular person won't do something good for you, but God is there in any of the way. God is going to be there for you, help you, and your act of kindness will always return back to you. In the same way, if you do something wrong with others, then also God is there to give you that wrong thing also. So be careful, whatever you are doing, do with pure heart. Okay, I hope you understood the story. We'll read the story from the book also, so that the lines and all everything is more clear. Okay children, now please open your books and see. Okay children, let's read from the book also. We are going to read lesson number 9, The Paper Crane. A man once owned a restaurant on a busy road. As we discussed, as I told you earlier also, there is a man who is the owner of a restaurant. And where was the restaurant? Restaurant was on a busy road. The road which is all the time busy and busy with the people. All the time, many one or the other person every time is going and coming on that road. He loved to cook good food and he loved to serve it. What did he love? He was, as I told you children, he was a gentle and a kind-hearted man. He cooked also very well. He loved to cook food and he also loved to serve it. Serve it means to give, when whosoever comes to his restaurant, he would like to make them eat his food. He worked from morning until night and he was happy. He was a very hard-working man. He worked all the time from morning till night and he was very happy with his work. But suddenly what happened? But a new highway was built close by. A highway was built, constructed close by his restaurant. So what was the effect of that highway? Travelers, the people who came to that place for having lunch or dinner, they just drove straight from one place to another and no longer stopped at the restaurant. Earlier what happened, this was a busy road. People, the travelers, the people used to come and stop there, have food and have fun, do shopping and all, whatever things are nearby that restaurant. But due to the construction of highway, the travelers just drove from one side of highway to the other side and they won't stop there at the restaurant. Many days went by when no guests came at all. What happened? Slowly few days went off and there were no guests at all at the restaurant. The man became poor and had nothing to do but dust and polish his empty plates and tables. The man, because there were no customers in his restaurant, so what happened? Slowly he became poor. So at the end, what was he left with? He was left only with the dust and polish his empty plates. Earlier the plates were filled with the food and all, the customers are coming having food and he used to get them washed and all for the next day. But now what was he left with? He was just left with the dust and polish his empty plates and tables. He just keep on doing, because no customers were there in his restaurant. One evening, a stranger came into the restaurant. What happened? In one evening, a stranger came into the restaurant. His clothes were old and worn. As I told you, the old man was not, that stranger was not in a good condition. He was wearing very old clothes and worn out clothes. Worn means beta, jo fate hue kapde. Okay. But he had an unusual gentle manner. But he was very gentle. He was not ashamed of being poor. He was a gentleman. Though he said he had no money for food, the owner invited him to sit down. What did this stranger do? As soon as he reached there, he told the restaurant owner that, "Dear, I'm not having any money for the food." But what did the owner do? He invited him to sit down. He said, "You come and sit down." He cooked the best meal he could make and served him like a king. Now, what did this owner did? He cooked whatever material, whatever food he was having, out of that he cooked the best he could make and served him and gave that food to the stranger and treated him like a king. When the stranger had finished, he said to his host. Host means the person who is dealing the stranger, the owner of the
restaurant was the host. I cannot, what did the stranger said to the host, to the owner? He said, I cannot pay you with money. As he's starting only, he said, I'm not having the money. So he repeated the same thing. I cannot pay you with money, but I would like to thank you in my own way. What did he said? Yes, of course I can pay it. I cannot give you the money, but of course I will surely give you words. I'll surely thank you in my own way. So what did he did? He picked up a paper napkin from the table and folded it into the shape of crane. From the table, he picked up the paper napkin and folded it and made a crane out of it. Crane is a bird. You have only to clap your hands. Now, what did he said? You just have to clap your hands, he said, and this bird will come to life. The paper crane is not original, but as soon as the stranger told the restaurant owner ki as soon as you will clap your hands, this bird life will come to this bird and it will dance for you. Take it and enjoy it while it is with you. Now what did the stranger said? Stranger said to the owner, now just you take this crane and enjoy it. With this, the stranger left. Telling this, the stranger left the restaurant. It happened just like that, like the stranger said. Now, what did the restaurant owner try? He tried doing the same and it happened. Whatever the stranger said happened to be truth. As soon as the restaurant owner clapped, the paper crane started dancing. The owner had only to clap his hands and the paper crane became a living bird, flew to the floor and danced. Okay, this all happened with the bird. Now, soon word of the dancing crane spread. Very soon what happened? This dancing crane rumor spread all over the area around the restaurant. And people came from far and near to see the magic bird perform. Of course, if you are having a paper and you made a crane or a bird from a paper, and if that paper crane start dancing, this is a magic. So many people from here and near and far just came to see the magic. The owner was happy again. Why was the owner sad, children? The owner was sad because there were no customers in his restaurant and he went off getting poor due to the lack of money. But now what happened? He was happy again, for his restaurant was full of guests. Now again, his restaurant was full of guests. He cooked and served and had company from morning until night. Now again, his circulation of cooking and serving started. The weeks passed and the months. Now slowly weeks, months passed. One evening, suddenly what happened? A man came into the restaurant. His clothes were old and worn, but he had an unusual and gentle manner. The owner knew him at once and was overjoyed. What happened, children? One evening, that very same man came to the restaurant and the owner was very happy to see him. The stranger, however, said nothing. He just took a flute. I told you, children, flute is a musical instrument. The stranger took that flute from his pocket, raised to his lips and began to play. He started playing that instrument. The crane flew down from its place on the shelf and danced as it had never danced before. The restaurant owner has, as you can see, the paper crane has kept the crane in the shelf. As soon as the stranger started playing the music with the help of flute, the crane started dancing. The stranger finished playing, lowered the flute from his lips and returned it to his pocket. Now slowly what happened? After finishing his playing of music, the stranger put that flute down from his lips and returned, keep it back in his pocket. What did the stranger did now? He climbed on the back of the crane and they flew out of the door and away. See, now you can see the picture also. This is a crane. A stranger is sitting on the back of the crane and flewing away. The restaurant still stands by the side of the road and guests still came to eat the good food and hear the story of the gentle stranger. That they of course have gone and they were never seen again by this restaurant owner, but the restaurant still stands and the guests were coming to eat the food, good food made by this good man, and they are also enjoying the story of the stranger and the magic crane made from the paper napkin. But neither the stranger nor the dancing crane has ever been seen again. But once they went off, they were never seen again.
Okay, I hope the story is clear to you, the summary also and from the book also. Read it once again, listen to the video, understand it, and if you have any doubt, please you can clear your doubts. I'll be sending you the question answers and all by the evening. Do your work by next Tuesday. Thank you so much, children.